All right, so starting 3, 2, 1, go. All right, so this is Super Mario Star. This is a hack created by Mizu, which was pretty much overshadowed popularity because this hack was released just 2 weeks after Super Mario 74, way back in 2011. And as you can see, starting Vanilla Overworld, not very much of this hack is custom, as you can see. Starting with course 1 here. So you can see how Vanilla Overworld, there are only 14 main courses and 2 secret stages changed in this hack. So we're gonna be traveling through the Vanilla Castle a lot. Oh, hello. And you also can see I only have Vanilla Lucky to come. Surprisingly works pretty well in most of the levels here. Oh, great.
You couldn't see very well.
So, yeah, like I mentioned, not every level has been changed in this hack. And the original levels from Vanilla that are untouched are still accessible, and you can still collect the stars from those levels. But I do think that for a speedrun, you know, you should only collect the stars that are changed, that are only unique to the hack itself. And this pretty much narrows down what stars can choose from. So this is 102 star, this is 100% 100% for the all the unique stars in the hack. And the ESC is 70 like Vanilla. So you have way less stars to choose from. And I don't know, okay. Yeah, there's no leaderboard for this hack. It was pretty much one of the listed hacks of the primary releases. That's why pretty much. And I just died again. Sorry, not very well. Yeah, this level is very reset heavy. You can see that there's a lot of narrow platform you have to go. Let's go this way then. And just to get your daily dose of cryptic star locations, you have that. Alright, let's try to get coins. So not all levels in this game have red coin stars, so I'll have to be collecting just hundreds and pair them with another red coin star for the most part. There's a echo random box here. Let's see, it's level 3 nerve-wracking. Well, that's hot, that's hot. Using only other capture, but... I can't help it, microphone is going crazy right now. I don't know how to avoid that with the microphone. Yes, microphone picking up the audio capture, I don't know why that happens. Yeah, this was in, this was an 2011 fight. Because if I lower down the volume on the microphone, you can't hear me anymore. Here we go! Okay, so the last star here is very close to the spawn. I do have my filter added to the microphone, but it still picks up for some reason. Okay, so next we're going to get a metal cap. It's located over the aquarium. And let's add another filter. I know. I couldn't hear my voice when I was testing audio. So this is metal cap stage. For some reason, it's imported over the aquarium. Over here, those are like two parallel walls that are very close to each other, and you can easily get stuck in them like this. So gotta make my way out. There you go. As you can see, one of the big features of this hack is you can see there are no fixed warps. Every level is gonna be accidentally out to course 1 painting. So don't be surprised if I enter course 1 again by mistake. So the next star here, you can get it capless, but I get a metal cap for safety because there's toxic gas down here. Okay, so that was all the stars in Metal Cap. We're doing actual course 3 now. I'm starting up with a funny ceiling skip here. Ceiling clip. Like that. Yeah. So like I said, that vanilla levels are still accessible in here. I still have to go to some of them. Not the best. Not the angle I wanted. Just another star there. Here we go! So time for coins. So in this hack, like I said, not all levels have red coin stars, and most levels that do have them only have 7 instead of 8 reds for some reason. So courses 3, 4, 6, 9, and 13 have and another secret stage have 7 red coins in the level. And the other exceptions are courses 10 and 12. 10 has 8 reds like normal, but for some reason 12 has 10 reds. So, you know. And yeah, going very close to a star for coins. Because there are a bunch of skitters in the same area. I'm gonna be doing that same ceiling clip again. Can I rest him? Like, we're sticking around for a little bit. There's a tango box right here. So Aglab is still around. I wanna try adding a second filter and see if that helps. Good night, everyone. Who's going to bed? I really want to stay focused on the game right now. Need 88. Okay. So yeah, like I said, there are only 7 reds here. Not okay. Just saying, if doubled audio is double audio is messing with your head. Yeah, I didn't want to use my older mic because last Saturday my voice sounded awful. I'm using my headset mic. And here's the last red. So we have 2 more stars left, I believe. Yeah. No, 3. Just saying, because I can see the lines on OBS here. So let's get a star. We skip the skitter room first. Clueless EV, clueless, 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 clueless. So the star coming up next, intended Well, intended for many of these stars is very, very slow, but thankfully there are skips that I'm doing. Just like that.
Here we go!
So we have one more star on the wall to the right. We have to take all the paths to get to the star, but we can just do this triple jump skip here. There you go. Although the single star is faster. Triple jump walk straight to the ledge, but when I tried it, it was very precise, so the single star only. So that's course 3 done. Time to go for some vanilla stages. First we're gonna go get into Wing Cap because we're gonna need it to, for several stars. Yes, Ludwig, for every level. It's fine. I was meant to ledge grab the switch. I'm gonna go get key one. We need it to progress. And for these unchanged levels, the warps do work, but ones that matter for the original stages don't. I was never the best at vanilla speedrun, so. See, the warp works here. So next, once that's out of the way, we're gonna be doing course 5 next. So this level is pretty linear. We're gonna be climbing the tower for almost every star. And there's gonna be several levels that are like this, the same level climb for every star in the level. Yeah, that's a duplicate Xbox ID from course 13 because course 13, you know, in vanilla has two areas, and in this game course 13 only has one area, so if you enter the other, the game will crash, and then you gotta do this. You can just press Wing Cap next to a star, you can collect it accidentally. So the reason I kill the big bull at that precise location is to be able to still get that star. Otherwise the star will spawn inside the wall and be unreachable. And so that's where I need to Wing Cap in the first place. Yahoo! Yahoo! just needs to do know how to place that star. Probably all the version of Hator back then was quite complex to use, I know. Okay, so this star. Have to break these boxes here. Who's getting in the way? And yet, most of these boosts are the ones that trigger the big one. But the there's not a big pool that are spawned from the smaller ones, you could say. But I guess, yeah. At least we know how to set properly stuff. Set things at the time. So let's get the star that we skipped before getting the one for the big pool. So the rest of the level is gonna be same level climb. I'm not gonna be talking too much because there's nothing that really stands out from every level. And doing the same exact movement every time.
Here we go!
So the next trip, I'm gonna get a 5-point star. With another star, it also requires them to the very top. And this level is varies quite slow for 70. I only get 2 stars here in 70. Because, well, I really had to consider the re-entry times from the course 1 painting. And I forgot the coins. Let's do the star step. This is the fastest star in the level, pretty much. Okay, let's try this again. See my splits, I'm missing one more star, I don't know which one I was. Oh, I know. I confused stars. Package KTS. KTS. Let's get the coins. That's not just what we were going for, actually. So I gotta be careful in this section because Vanilla BBH camera can trigger. And if you have a... if you trigger a Vanilla BBH camera, like hardcore one, you cannot do close-up Maragam anymore. Or when you switch cameras, you can't do far away Maragam. Hope you understand what I mean, but... I'm still focused on the game right now. Yeah, vanilla hardcore with PBH camera really can mess up things here. Cordoba can really mess things up, but he really fell off. He has the last 3 boosts here for Hundreds. So last star, I have to climb all the way up and then jump to a lower tower. I can't make the jump if I try to long jump from a lower distance or lower height, I mean. And that's course 5 done. So we're gonna go start up the basement right now. So my goal here, since there are no fixed warps and every level takes you back to course 1, is trying to do the longer levels as soon as possible. Most of them are located upstairs. So I want to get both keys as soon as possible to go upstairs. I'm gonna start course 8 here. So I want to get the restart as soon as possible, so I can go get key 2 and from there go to upstairs. So this level again, same clip for every star. At least gonna beat this shell right over quicksand here. And I'm gonna start with coins first. I honestly don't know why the mic is picking up the audio from the game, honestly. Kinda starting to drive nuts seeing that. Didn't have my older mic, but I didn't want to use it because how bad the audio sounds. And I think I'm... There, as you spoiled what I was going to say. Can someone ban Terrence, Kappa? And just precisely what happened, I didn't consider that. This is bad. Well, at least I can show that, showcase that. Where is he going? Because pathways are kinda broken, because it's not shifting sandland here. I'm gonna tap him once. Nah, that's not a... That's not a ritual location, I'm gonna have to try again. I'm not gonna understand in the meantime. What's it be? Ah, yes. Let's try to get back. Stuck in the same location. And the cap's gonna fall down to the same pretty much. No? No, I saved the game, so I will remain without the cap. Usually, Klepto gets stuck in one same occasion when I had it happening, but for some reason I'm not getting that here. It's making getting up impossible. Hope it's not actually possible. You can see I'm skipping maps because it's a vanilla star. Really, I didn't know that, especially when I actually played DS. I never had that happening, I don't remember. Okay, that didn't know that worked. Now where is... Really losing time, values time for the run. To get him cut back. But estimate is generous, so I can anticipate having long deaths throughout the run. And I just can't see him anymore. Oh, there he is. I was clearly looking in the wrong place. Can you piss off? Alright. Back in business. See, I told you I was gonna try to instinctively re-enter course 1. So what do I have left? Okay. So kinda went way off my route, my usual route for this level. So for this star that was gonna originally collect when I got hundreds, I have to attack Klepto. So he doesn't steal my cap.
Here we go!
Oh yeah, the follow runner text, thanks for it. So this star... for this star I used the shell to go to some floating platforms, floating plane platforms. But I'm not sure if it's actually faster to... we just walk on them. They're not quicksand. And I'm going away. Let's go. Walking on them. And they're not even slow sand. So we have one more star left. This is probably the fastest star in the level. At least it wasn't my timing, since it's the only star that I do in 70. Lol, there is. Thought that would work. Gotta do a blind jump here. And I missed it.
Mamma mia!
So yeah, that's here can lose like a minute because you have to do double re-entries. As opposed to you had big swaps, so it would just take like 10, 20 seconds, I think. Wouldn't be that much time. Like Sibu would say, not scared. Okay, now I usually try to go fast because I don't want to have to attack me.
Here we go!
Okay, so we have 3 stars. That means we can go to course 9 now. And since you remember from Vanilla, you need course 9 star 1 to get Kito. Woo! So Star One is down here on this super boss over here. And we're gonna be getting people during course night split. So now we have course night Star One, we can go to Bowser 2. And I'm honestly not sure that how Vanilla 70 Star Guns work. But I'm pretty sure you get both Red Coin Stars and also one Bowser 2 in 70 in Vanilla. Because they're well on the path to the fight, but I might be wrong, I'm not sure. So it might feel kinda weird climbing Bowser 2 without getting reds. Just a nice, funny, pretty demon challenge thing. If I collect one up, that means I'm going very slow. Yes, you still have the melee adventure run, so gonna be probably too late to watch the terminal room. I still got pretty long way to go also. So you can see, we got a fixed warp so we can re-enter course 9 pretty quick. Yes, if you warp out it. I don't know why I'm doing this terrible, but I usually did coins after Kito. Might be too sleepy, I don't know. Now we're doing quests. Now we take this path for one little blue reds here. You're back. Gonna be opening the gun here for a later star.
Here we go.
Going the wrong way. That now has no cut. Okay, let's get started again next. So you know the people that are two stars were in the rooms I went before where I didn't get any stars in. Two more stars left. And that wraps up course 9. Next we're gonna go upstairs. We're gonna be starting with course 10 because it's one of the harder levels in the game. Starting off on this star on this side. It's very easy to fall off here. And also these gnomes are here to annoy you every step of the way. Just like that. Yeah. careful with these snowmen because they can... Hitting them kind of almost guarantees you to fall. We don't want that. But we made it. Skip here. You see that box over there? You have to break it, there's a star in the bottom. You could use metal cap, low saver, but it's slower. Because falling down with the metal cap, it's much slower than point swimming. So this star next, or is when we actually need a metal cap. We're gonna be going through this section here. Kinda makes me feel like in a road tunnel in metal cap in the pressure walls. Let's do the coins now, get them out of the way. Like I said, there are 8 reds here. Coins, which is kind of precise, especially because they have the snow wave things here. I don't know how exactly it's called. That's the best I could route the blue coins. Fine. That's because there's a red here. If you fall down that hole, you can't. Well, there's a star. You might be able to come back from it, but I never actually tried it myself. Okay. I need to kill the other snowman to complete 100. So I have the swimming star and the other the star in the pole, okay. So of course that's not not terrible so far. I've had worse string looks in other attempts I've done. And I think it's not a good idea to a swimming star. It's cold water and you die much faster. Swimming a bunch. The one drew with men. Thanks for luck.
Here we go!
So next we're going back to the basement. We're gonna be doing let's clean up. We're gonna be using the metal cap pretty frequently in this level. Starting up with this star. I'm kinda on a tight cap cycle here. Because this patch is a bit long. And also, you can get the star from above, but it's lower. So. Let's do the first step. Since I already got a metal cap.
Here we go! Wahoo!
So for this start we're gonna be doing a shell ride up. The shell is located above the entrance of the hall here. What do you want to happen?
Mamma mia!
That's the start over there. So I'm gonna try something to fix the audio. You're not gonna be hearing me, of course, but the other stars, well, you're gonna see what I mean. We're gonna be basically getting to the same areas, you know. Some hundreds and the stars inside, and the last star, two more stars. One is on a roof, and use lucky to come instead of the angle. And the last star, it's a kind of a secret. I'll let you know.
Chat to check. I'm quiet. Okay. I'm gonna have to raise my voice. You hear the audio like probably. I have to raise one notch. I changed all the sources.
So this star, I call it the Viking star, you're gonna see why. Pretty fast start. Start here that I'm going to last level in the basement is score 6. And we're gonna be entering a segment of the gauntlet of long levels. And that's precisely because of that. Because I got a lot of increases and stuff like that. This is now another level where you're gonna be doing the same thing forever. We start. And this level is actually really tight on coins, so we're gonna be killing almost every enemy. Sorry, no, we'll start the first three jumps here. First star is over there on the floor. I'm gonna wait for the cycle to jump. That's fine. Here we go.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Here we go.
At least from what you can see, what I can see, the game is not audible double.
Let's go!
Let's switch here. Do some boxes.
Here we go!
Alright, see how this appears. Lower the game volume a little bit, but still kinda loud. Where am I going here? I found it.
Get it mixing up.
And I don't want to get an assign on another level. So we have one more step with tricky jumps, then we're going to do coins.
Let's go. Woo!
I got two more steps. Yeah. This one. Yeah. I just missed one. So like I said, stack of coins now. Yeah. that can be discounted. Went back to the previous setting. Because I honestly could hear my voice very, very bad. We need Aglav here. Guess I wasn't looking where I was going. Alright, that scores 6 done. So now we only have left this. We still have some Overworld 1 cleanup to do, but we're gonna do upstairs first. So, what's next? We're gonna go in course 13 next. Here is a sign that says that the game will freeze if you enter that painting. Yeah, for some reason my microphone is capturing game audio as well. Aglav said he'd show me how to change it, but he's not around. So this level is like a 3 level with 3 floors. Gonna be getting the stars from top to bottom. Wanna see that work? Okay.
Here we go.
Yeah, it's doing the math, it's what do you call it? Work hours. I already kinda messed up with settings, but it didn't work out really. Nothing was fixed. Miscalculate the jump. Yeah. Well, let's start with the coins now. I remember this time. I usually forget where the next coins are. Okay, the big Goombas. Drop ground pounds, otherwise, gonna be missing opponent coins. Here. Press this blue coin switch here. Plenty of blue coins in the same spot. Couple kill, one more. Get out of hand. I'm going coin short. Yeah. Alright, this is my last attempt at trying to fix the audio, like it works. Come on around to let me know. Hear my voice loud and clear. So the solution was adding a second filter. I had one, I added another different one, it worked. So okay, try talking. I'll continue talking. So this star here I consider a third floor star. You can see I'm gonna fall all the way down to the very bottom. I still got a good hole climb. And these gates here are the ones that you open with the switch. These was those objects. Look. Status pads. Gonna see for gates later. I guess didn't bother adding a one way wall or something like that. Or at least a textured gate like that. Probably easier to use these objects here. Okay, so final confirmation if audio is alright, my voice, game audio not duplicating itself and so on, close everything, and not have my monitors scattered with a bunch of settings windows. What? Thanks, Katie. Asking again, final confirmation. Can I close everything now? Also, yeah, the star just got just randomly hidden in a bunch of flowers, you know. I got the wrong star. Break. Yeah, I usually get the other stuff first and then this tiny flowers last, but all of these audio settings is really messing up my muscle memory. Okay, okay. Okay, I'll laugh, I will. Dude, so based, Jinty, so fucking based. Alright, I can clear my mind now, please. All this trouble, first half of the run. At least more than half of the run. First 13 done. Four more levels left. That'll be the one we know. Four levels left upstairs. No, three levels upstairs left. Going to the furthest, cross 14. No locator on TTC. So, sorry about the hack. This hack was originally going to have a course 15, but somehow Nisu couldn't add it to the game. So the hack was left with only 14. And he meant to add the hack, the last level, this hack in another project, but that never really came to existence. So this is what we got. I'm gonna start by doing this reference to my favorite star in Dark Stars. How long can you keep ball kicking? I'm gonna be going here for 3 stars. And I think I did wanna go for this jump, yeah. Fine, I can make my way through. Gonna go carefully. Ah, one more. Boxing. Boxing, CB, boxing. Here we go! Y hermano, ¿qué pasa? Qué bueno verte. Bien. You know what I mean? My brain is half asleep, I see. Didn't get enough sleep trying to set up everything. Of course, what's a SRM without having a TGN sleep schedule? Yeah. Hey, Yagla. Pretty tricky to where you're going, plus camera. Here. Just drop down for this star. Intended is different, I think. Here we go! I actually don't remember how I got the star in the first place when I first played through this hack. Yeah. Oh, you can see this level is pretty far away from this one, course one. Crusoe Clan City has pretty fast stars, actually. I get 6 stars queuing 70. I just noticed I haven't used most of my notes. And memorized them. For writing them. So let's do coins now. Gonna be pairing them with R1. Getting some backup coins here. Never mind. I think I'm screwed. If I don't mess up less coin grabs, I should be fine. Also, I usually complete hundreds with that box. I'm too scared to jump very high that the star won't be attainable because spawning too high. Stars here. One. Then it's pretty long. Have to go around the level. A similar way to other stars where you have to go on paths on the walls. But I can just do this long jump here. And free star. Star. It's kind of opposite to the path where I got star 1. Alright, that's course 14 done. Next we're going to course 12. And we're gonna be raging a lot for Liga RNG. I'm depending on it for 2 stars here. There are 2 backup stars that I can get here if I that guy doesn't cooperate. There we go. That's the first one. So intended for this star is using a climbable ceiling, but we know that it's slow as hell, so we're trying to find faster ways to collect these stars. Next Fly Guy Star. The intended for this one is using some boxes, but I can just abuse Fly Guy here.
Here we go!
So surprising pretty well Fly Guy RNG I've had. I've honestly had worse Fly Guy RNG in previous attempts. Alright, let's do the coins. Like I said, there are 10 reds here. For this next red, I will have to use a climbable ceiling to get it. Hopefully nothing goes wrong, otherwise I'm gonna have to reset the game. I'll explain when I get there. Intended for that red is using the boxes. I'm gonna do any slow hands here. We're gonna be doing a series of freaky jumps here. So that barrier around the pole there can cause you to soft block, so I prefer not falling there. I did tangle for this. And the Koopa didn't get away. Beast. This here. I always fail to figure out which walls are as I should use. But we're out now. Yeah, if you fall down that section of the pole, top lock pretty much, you can't come back. I have the backup stars left and another star. Okay. I go around because jumping over and just hitting invisible walls, you're pretty much dead. Okay, Fly Guy saved me. But there's a hidden star on that wall over there. And I somehow still managed to get inside. No, they are unrelated. The creators, they're from very different places. Izu is from Venezuela, Itoji is from France, so they're unrelated, but their titles are pretty similar. Like, even Starlord could be easily confused. Also, talking about where Kray is from, you can see that the stars have poorly written English, probably. Because Mr. Kray didn't know properly English at the time. Probably used a bunch of Google Translates for naming every star. Like, you wouldn't call this star inside of the Earth. Okay, so scale the mountain is the next one. Just locate it down here. We have one more level left upstairs, it's course 11. If I lost time, this level might be weak, because enemies and jumps here can be pretty annoying. Fine, with this one. Done with the coins now. So for the next 4 stars I'm gonna be climbing up top part of the level. And there are plenty of heap holes in that area and they can easily pop, fall down, take big fall damage. Dying is very likely. Like, this hippo can be very annoying. There was these ones on this narrow bridge, I think. I almost fell off again.
Here we go! Here we go.
Also, I, well, you've seen it, I didn't mention it, what's happening? Name is called El Callejón, in Spanish. Don't know if that was intentional on Mrs. Father or not. Translates to like the alleyway. Okay, let's do the last star in the top section, where you climb up and then fall down. Alright. That will do.
Here we go!
Right, so just two busy stars left. So this first one is the star in the jail. And they also have the same problem of having two parallel walls close to each other where you can get stuck, but jump kicks backwards does the job here. And last star in the zoo. It's located in this kind of river over here. Believe it or not, this was actually a goal split. I never got a very good course 11 any run. For the only goals I've gotten in this run. So that's upstairs done. All you have left is overworld 1 or lobby cleanup. I'm starting the course for here. So I'm gonna be starting with the coins here. This is the longest redstone contest in the game. Getting these takes the same time as the other 5 stars combined, so you can see how long. That's because I had to kill a lot of snowmen here. I didn't do it. We're gonna be using the makeup here. I believe it was unintended for this level, but it's added here. Oh, gonna take advantage of it. And also, I just remember that you can also get softlocked here. In another section coming up. I actually had a run die due to softlocking very late into point start here. Because getting both stars again pretty much cost all of the time saved that I had. I think I can come up. Probably lost track of my coin count. I need to have 91 before right big line. But in this section, if you go on foot through here, you soft lock. Well, better to jump. Okay, just time the mountain on the very bottom. And this Nomad has just the coins that I need. Make my way back up, I need to have 91. Just killed Fly Guy for the last coin instead of the snowman. And that's the coins done. Almost 5 minutes from what I see here in my splits. You're gonna see that 5 stars are very, very fast. Okay. I get 5 of 7 in 70. Look at that, I hit the course one by accident. Wouldn't, don't be surprised if that happens. I would like the flag guy to move over here, but I need it. Use for the star and okay. I'm gonna try one last time. Do the fire guys in a good position. Alright. Otherwise I'll be too be able to get the... I could use the wake up for this star, but it's slower. These two stars. So there's a star here, just find on the wall here. If I miss a star, I would get the star you see on the bottom. The backup. Now let's get that star now. Here we go. You can see they're pretty fast. Okay, this for this star we'll be using the blink up. Because it's way faster. Then you're supposed to use some switch box with this. And that is way slower. Come on. Guess I'm not getting this hard.
Here we go.
But let's start here. I'm gonna be jumping to an area with a bunch of snowmen. Didn't land straight on the start, but that's fine.
Here we go.
That's course 4 done. Have one more main course left, that is course 2. That is pretty much the easiest level in the game. You'll see. There's nothing that is pretty tricky. The skips are, but level 10 is very, very easy. I saw with this skip here. Obviously Bonk it wasn't such because there are a bunch of Koopas here. There. Just like that. Then you have to use switch box that you have to press from below, but get you rid of that. Next, this part. So intended for this star is to walk all the way through this, like around this area, but you can use that crazy box to get this, to get here. You can see over there how much you have to walk, but crazy box is hard. Come with the coins. These are pretty fast. Because there are plenty of coins around the level. Woo! Gotta be careful with the fire there. And just like that, have a convoy star. Be free. And this time I'm going to get this at the bottom of these boxes here. Well, I honestly don't know how exactly to use this intended, but for a speedrun all I do is swim under the level and get the star from there. Because there's no like clear entrance essentially. And for this star, we have to jump. We have to kind of climb the around the structure a little bit, and then do a long jump of fate. That star over there. And there you go. Here we go! Alright, so let's start here. This is the only specific star in the hack. You're gonna be climbing to an arch, like you saw in the start name. And you need some metal boxes that only appear on Act 6, so yeah, you can see that this star is expensive. First, using these time switch boxes to get up, but I missed. Yes, I got up. I almost didn't go through. Watch muscle them. There. And these are the metal boxes that I mentioned. They are like specific. Last level here is located on the slide. The level itself has no name, has the same name from Vanilla, but the layer in the star display calls it Quicksand Pit, and that's precisely what it is. I'm gonna go in around collecting rest first. And like I said, or probably didn't, I don't remember, that there are only 7 reds here. And be careful avoiding the tornadoes, otherwise death. Because if you touch a tornado, you lose the shell. We have one more star left, and but run is not gonna be over because we still have to final boss fight now, Vanilla. But just so you know. Come on. can do a double jump off that box, but I pump this triple jump more consistent, but I'm choking it. There. Right. That's every star in the game done. Just have to find a final fight, and we're done. And we're looking at a sub 210 pacer. Honestly, not that terrible. Just, you know, making our way to Boss 3, climbing, getting into the fight, and we're done. All right, let's do this. Like I said, I'm not the best at the moment. I don't know many of the faster strats you do. No. Well, I guess that's a rip up to 10 because gold is pretty much perfect. Perfect line, perfect fight, throws and everything. Go rep. Is the triple jump there? I'm gonna bother trying to get it again. Look at that, I just totally missing all of the platform cycles here. That gives me another attempt at the... And I kinda had it, but just totally messed it up again. Now we're good. DBA Yosef, honestly. Alright, just, you know, the usual final fight, three throws and we're done. Hardly. I honestly didn't know what a bomb was. I'll break off, please. Okay, then we're just going for content, you know? There is no throws, eh? Definitely not a throw, see? There, fine. Alright, That's Super Mario Star. Old classic Locker in the Shadows. Sometimes a good old 74. And time. That's 2:11:41. Kinda went the same pace as my previous practice round that I did. So pretty decent. Thanks for all the GGs, everyone. That's 13 minutes behind PB, with all the technical issues I had for the first half of the run. Hopefully you still enjoyed. And not went insane for all the audio issues. So to finish off, I want to give a few shoutouts. First is the bell ring for creating the special with the single star timings that I used to route this, because since pretty much no one has actually done routings for every level in the game, I didn't have a way to test my strats, so bell ring should help with these timings, and sometimes even far faster with the strats that I developed. And that's the first one. The second one is Starlight Sims. For his playthrough, he did a few strats that I found useful. Also, for some insight on how to route coin stars, because some of the coins were very spread out in some levels. And the third person is Nora, or the Scrub as she was formerly known, for doing 90% runs with a few strats here and there in a few levels. Because those were my only references that I had for routing this hack. And I think it turned out pretty well, like, got a sub 2, my PB is a sub 2, and game could be much faster if it had actual and fixed warps. I plan to ask Misu for permission to update the hack myself. Hopefully he'll agree, because I honestly got sick of doing Vanilla Climb over again. I thought it wouldn't be that long, but with 100 stars, it kinda gets to you, you know? That's it for me, hope you enjoyed this run. I'll be seeing you tomorrow for my next run, which is U-Star 132 non-stop. And I'm leaving you to the next run, which is the Melee Adventure by one of the many Andrews we have. This is AJD. So, yeah, moving on to the next run.